नमस्कार, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर प्रभा विष्ट एंड आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ होम साइंस गवर्नमेंट पीजी कॉलेज डोईवाला देहरादून एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट माय व्यूज ऑन रीबिल्डिंग भारत पोस्ट कोविड-19 विद आईसीटी बेस्ड इंटरवेंशंस एंड आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस इन पब्लिक हेल्थ एंड न्यूट्रिशन एंड बिफोर आई स्टार्ट माई प्रेजेंटेशन आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक एंड कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट गौतम बुद्ध यूनिवर्सिटी फॉर कंडक्टिंग दिस फर्स्ट ऑनलाइन इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस एंड क्रिएटिंग लर्निंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस एंड द थीम ऑफ दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस इज सो relevant and it much in demand that I believe truly believe by the end of this presentation this by the end of this conference actually the views ideas of all the participants would help us in bouncing back. So I'm starting my presentation now. I'll talk about food, nutrition, health and immunity first. Food is the base for our survival and it is a prerequisite for nutrition. Similarly, nutrition is a prerequisite for health and immunity. We were talking a lot about immunities these days and in the wake of coronavirus, as we all know that there's no approved drug or medicine or vaccines for this corona spread disease. So what we are left with? We are left with our immunity. We are depending on our immunity. And we've been recently doing many things to improve our immunity. We are relying on our traditional methods of using more of turmeric, sipping every half an hour the hot water, or you know, using all the spices, condiments, just to improve our immunity. Because immunity is the only power that will help us in fighting this disease. That is what we believe actually. So what I'm trying to say is, good nutrition plays a very important role in enhancing health and nutrition of an individual. Now I'll talk about ICT. ICT, I'm not a technical person, I'm a layman and my knowledge ICT is just limited as a, this is a generic term I would say, and it is used for, you know, collecting, sorting, editing, storing and disseminating informations. And information and communication technologies have emerged as a viable source of gathering and dispersing nutrition informations. And there have been so many research that have proved that ICT enabled interventions and artificial intelligence have improved the health and nutritional status of population all over the world. And but this was not always like this. Before a few years back, we were in denial stage. Few years back, IT was not the way of our life for most of us. And these are two statements I have taken for this presentation. One is from Western Union memo, and it says this telephone, it was when the telephone was invented, and it says this telephone has too many shortcomings to be seriously considered as a means of communication. This device is practically of no use to us. And now you can imagine the scenario. And the other was from Thomas Watson, who was chairman IBM in the year 1943. Imagine his assumption for worldwide need for computer that time was just 5 computers. Now scenario has changed. These are the realities from today. And as an individual, as a layman, that is how I use ICT in my life. It is when I am working and when I am not working. So these nowadays, YouTube, Facebook, Amazon, eBay and so many other things have become an essential part of our life. Now I'll talk about ICT intervention and artificial intelligence in public health and nutrition. These are the 6 main areas where most of the developed countries have been working, and to some extent in India also we are using ICT interventions and AI in our public health and nutrition sector. These areas are big data and pandemic predictions. Nowadays every now and then we see so many predictions coming from universities, like they predict these many numbers will have numbers of patient corona patients India is going to have by the end of April, May or June, and they also predict when is this corona thing is going to happen over. And the other is machine learning and blood glucose management. That was the another aspect of this ICT intervention. Third is database technology and health factor monitoring. Health monitoring in the area of and health and nutrition, nutritional status assessment and growth monitoring, we've been using it a lot. And then comes face recognition and emotional analysis. Fourth one is medical analysis and prediction of human life. Last one is health management and quality of life improvement. These, as I told you before, these are the areas very much popular in the Western countries. But in India, we still have to think and we still have to use in a broader perspective. The third is ICT in public health and nutrition. ICT as as I told you, information communication technology. For a layman like me, who is working in nutrition area or public health area, it can be divided into two parts. One is standalone applications, and other is online application. So standalone application would be these are the areas where these are the softwares or apps which we purchase or we prepared by ourselves, and once we have purchased them or we prepared them, we don't need internet connection for this. And these applications are very much in demand, and they have been very, very useful as compared to the conventional method of working in nutrition areas, like in field. When we work in field, contemporary methods of these using these softwares have been very fruitful, less time consuming and economic as well. So these standalone applications are nutrient analysis of softwares, food services, recipe management, clinical nutrition, drug nutrient interaction, health risk management, lifestyle prescription, food and nutrition education, traffic packages, as we see in the student material, in especially educating the children. And the other one is online applications. They also have their importance. Email, websites, food and nutrition online services, social medias, electronic bulletin board systems, telemedicines, mobile apps, digital libraries. Now I'll talk about the finest example of using information communication technology based real-time monitoring. In India, we all know about Poshan Abhiyan. Poshan Abhiyan is a Prime Minister's overarching scheme for holistic nourishment, and it is also known as Rashtriya Poshan Mission. So it aims to eradicate malnutrition by the year 2022. And in ICT RTM, what they are doing is the Aganwadi workers who are working under integrated child development services, they have been given a software-based application in the form of mobile form, and now the whole scenario has been changed. And through this ICT RTM, we have better grip over malnutrition. So this was the example. Now I'll come to the main areas of focus areas where we need to work as a nutritionist, and I would request all the IT experts to come and collaborate. And these are the areas where we need to work most so that we can meet the contemporary issues, nutritional and health issues, and societal needs for the betterment of health and nutrition. And as I told you, developed countries, they have been working very hard and they have been working very smartly in these areas, and they have the better results also. And these areas will help us in growing as a country. And investing in nutrition is the best investment because it reflects in our GDP. Because once the health and nutritional status of the population is taken into consideration, rest of the things can be managed. And after corona, post-corona situation, we would need more and more such interventions. So I hope all the IT people and nutrition people, they can come together and they can work on these things. One thing I must admit before I end my presentation, diet and nutrition cannot directly control any disease or any pandemic situation, but it does have a very important role in fighting, in creating a better environment for the growth of nation. Thank you very much.